Hi folks, today we'll see a new concept, that is casting and coercion. This is a very general concept of any programming language and is important. Casting is a process by which you treat an object type as another type, and coercing is converting one object to another. Firstly, we'll see what is the usage of casting and coercion, and then we'll see how we can use it. Consider there is a boy, Rahul, who got these marks in his exams. In maths, he got 89. In science, he got 75.5. In history, he got 70.5. And in English, he got 80. So how the average is being calculated here? Here, we have two types of numbers. These are float and integer. If we see from the above, calculating the average may seem easy. Now, go back to the day where you learned addition of decimal numbers in maths. When we don't have any value after decimal point and we have to add it to a number which have decimal, then we imagined that there is a decimal whose letter digit is 0. And then we add the two numbers. The case is very much similar here. When we have to do some operations with different types of numbers, then we use coercion. If we have to add 4.5 and 5, then we have to convert 5 to 5.0. This is coercion. So let's see now how we can do casting and coercion. In Python, we have these 5 fundamental data types. And as we saw that, for handling each data type, we have a class. For producing the data for a specific type, we have constructors. Now, what the heck is this constructor? The constructor is used to create an object of a class. We will see the constructor in the OOPS part in detail. So now, for example, to produce an int data, we will use the constructor of int class. We have to pass a parameter in the constructor. This parameter should be a valid numeric value in case of int with no exceptions. And the parameter we will pass will be converted to that data type. So let's see this in detail. We will make a new folder inside Python, that is 7 casting coercion. And inside this, we will again make a folder, one int. In this folder, we will have only the int data type. And now a new file, a.py. We will call the constructor of class int. Here we have to pass an int value. Let's say 12. And we will assign it to a variable. Let's say x. And print x. Now let's run cd 7 casting 7 underscore c tab and cd 1 tab. Okay. I'm using the tab key to complete the name of the directory. Okay. Now python a.py. We have passed an int value and we are getting an int value. No change. Okay. Now let's see a new example, b.py. Let x is equal to int 7.22. And we will print this, print x. Running b.py. Okay, here we can clearly see the task of int constructor. We have passed a float value in the parameter and in the output, we are getting an int value. This is the task of int constructor to convert any number into an integer. Okay. Now what if we have a numeric string? Let's see. New example. c.py. X is equal to int 12 in string. And we will print x. Let's run this. c.py. Okay, so the numeric string is converted into an integer. Okay, How we can say so confidently that the returned value is int only? We can use here type function to confirm that. So after printing x, we can print type of x. And now running c.py. See, the class of x is int, so it is confirmed that the returned value is int and not string. Let's see what happens if we have a float number as a string. X is equal to int 12.5 in string and running c.py. Invalid literal for int with base 10, 12.5, okay. So here we are getting the error for literal 12.5, means we can't convert a string of float numbers to int, okay. And we will obviously get an error if we have a non-digit string, okay. So let's see this also. X equal to int ABC. Okay, so this is giving an error. Okay. Now what about Boolean? In Boolean, true means 1 and false means 0. So let's see if we get 1, 0 or error for Boolean string. Okay. X equal to int true inside string. And now running c.py. Error. So here only one case is working. The rest is giving the error. Okay. Now new example d.py. In this, let's take the type Boolean. We saw that we can't convert Boolean string to int. Here we'll take the Boolean only, okay. X is equal to int true with t in uppercase and print x. Now running d.py. Notice here we are able to convert Boolean to int. Okay, so remember we can't do this if we have a Boolean in string, but if we have Boolean then it can be converted to int. Okay, you can check for false also, it will return 0. So now new example a.py. Now we are left with the complex data type only. So let's see if we can convert complex to int or not. X is equal to int 2 plus 3j and print x. Running e.py. Okay, here we are getting the type error. Can't convert complex to int. Okay, so we can't convert complex to integer data type. Okay. So this is all for today. We will see the float constructor in the next lecture. Thank you.